It was sickening. But my second thought, and yes, I am working my way through it, although it's very difficult, it's not unlike the stories I've been hearing from survivors in the last 5 years who were abused by clergy in the Archdiocese of Baltimore.
That is Gemma Hoskins, former Archbishop Keough High School student, an investigator on the 7-part Netflix series The Keepers. You'll recall Vats was talking about the investigation of the murder of Sister Kathy Sesnick from the 1970s, but she was also talking about that grand jury report last week in Pennsylvania, hundreds of priests accused of molesting children and others over
predator priest
decades.
Is what they were called,
predator
Robert.
Predator priest.
That was the name in the 900-page report by Attorney General Josh Shapiro. Another part of that, you know, she actually called into our show last week as
yes,
well.
Yes, she did. On
Abby Schaub, her partner, who actually did the work with her, is the fact that, you know, we need in Maryland, and I understand that Attorney General Brian Frosch and his office is saying they neither confirm nor deny.
Standard procedure. And you know what? They were, when I asked them that, and they also, I also mentioned Craig Wolf's name, and I think they were offended by that.
That's the opponent, right, running against
him. But as a former prosecutor, and they say he should know this, that that is standard procedure.
I get that, Robert.
And what Josh Shapiro did was not give status reports. Josh Shapiro said,
this is a conclusion we've reached. But when you have something this groundbreaking that has made the Pope Francis, weigh in as an international issue, there are exceptions to the rule. The general public needs to know now, and victims, I believe, need to know now that the Attorney General of the State of Maryland is looking into this. We don't need updates. We don't need status updates. But just the fact that they're investigating this, to me, is worth the public interest for them to come forward and say this.
Has Gemma Hoskins or any of the, and you've had some survivors and their heartbreaking calls, have they contacted
absolutely. They've called, they said they called the Attorney General's office. They've given their information. They haven't been told what is going to happen next. But I'm just saying that, to me, all of the Attorney Generals looking into their individual states, this rises to the level of at least informing your public, because these are publicly elected officials, these Attorney Generals work for us, that we're looking into it. Don't violate confidentiality. Don't violate what's ongoing. But just the fact of looking into it, I believe, Robert, gives hope to the victims of these crimes, as well as to communities, that there's something looking into it or going on.
Another story I want to talk to you about is the University of Maryland football team. And we heard again from Martin McNair, the father of Jordan McNair, who said that President Wallace Lowe, the University of Maryland president, should not be fired.
It was a statement that he issued through their attorney, Billy Murphy, and and Hassan Murphy. Look, I understand that, and you can never, you know, when a parent's lost a child, you can never say anything to make that whole or do. But this situation is bigger than Jordan McNair. The tragedy of the loss of this 19-year-old is one thing, but how the football program was run, was it a toxic culture? Why did Rick Court, the athletic director, the athletic guy, get a $350,000 payoff? All these are questions that Dr. Lowe needs to face, and if there aren't good answers, and the Board of Regents find there aren't good answers, he's got to go. And I don't care what the parents at this point are saying in terms of that part of it. They will be made whole, at least temporarily, in terms of finances, resources.
Sure.
But as it relates to this decision, this isn't their call.
You got the sense the Board of Regents acted last week because they thought, as Dwight Pettit pointed out on your show, former regent, that President Lowe acted prematurely.
Precipitously. And I believe, Robert, that things we might not know, that they don't trust the president running this process. I mean, how else can you analyze it when they take all of it away from him? It's three different investigations going on,
right,
and they're taking it under their control. I truly believe that the when you get to the bottom of this, the athletic director is in trouble with this, Damon Evans. I think, of course, DJ Durkin, the coach, but also think the president. As much as I like Dr. Lowe, I think Dr. Lowe and the decisions he made, particularly that one from the Washington Post story,
right,
where he said that the medical decisions would still go through the football team as opposed to the University of Maryland Hospital. That's problematic, Robert.
C4 show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 10.